Namaste, this is Mekhala here from poojas.in. This episode is going to be something which all working professionals would love to watch, because today I'm going to answer one of your questions, the most again sought questions by working professionals. So they say, ma'am, how do we handle a bad boss? So I thought, okay, there is a solution for this also. Let me share the astrological solution on how you can handle your bosses. So basically, it is our ego which makes a person good or bad, because we also vibrate in a certain frequency. And when we behave in a particular way, it emits vibrations and then they respond back to that. So how we respond to people, are we attracting enough? Are we attractive enough to impress our bosses? I'm not talking about the physical beauty or aspect. I'm talking about how much effort you're putting. Is it recognized by your boss? Or is your boss always trying to nitpick and find fault in you no matter how you perform? Or is it that you yourself are really not performing well, which is actually creating these problems? You know, there are various aspects to this, and today I'm going to only handle a particular aspect wherein you believe that you're performing very well, despite of which your boss is not recognizing you. You want to give your best shot, and still your boss is not somehow allowing you to express yourself freely in your profession. So when you are in this kind of a situation, astrologically we recommend you to do some very simple remedies. And again, week on week when you do these, you will start seeing changes in your office and workplace, especially the attitude of your boss towards you. So the first thing I would recommend is, if you are low on a budget and you want to see some changes, try donating at least 1 kg of wheat grains every Sunday to a poor person. Now, when we individually recommend this remedy to people, they come back to me and say, can we give atta, can we give rotis and all that. See, all that you can do, you can expand. But primarily, what I am suggesting is an astrological remedy. So, I am insisting that you should give wheat grains. But it's a practical problem that, you know, you give grains and it's of no use to the person unless it's ground into a flour, right? So what you do is you give them some money to make it into a flour. So give wheat grains and some dakshina, whatever you can, so that they can go and, you know, make rotis with that and whatever is the process involved in that. Okay, so this is something that I want you to try. Do it for 12 Sundays. Okay, donating wheat grains to poor people for 12 Sundays. And every Sunday when you do, you will see a change. Okay, so this is one thing that you can do. But if you do not have budget constraints, for example, you slightly like, you know, I don't mind spending a bit more, I want to see quick results, then you should go for a Surya Abhisheka. So usually Surya Abhisheka comes within 1800 rupees. You can get it done on one Sunday of a month. That's good enough. What, you know, you start with once in a month and then you go on increasing or decreasing depending on the response you get from your boss. So if you have a budget of 1800 rupees per month to please your boss, or to, you know, convert that from bad to good mode, then you can definitely try the Abhisheka. It's very powerful. But don't go to a place where Navagrahas, all the grahas are there and Surya is one of them. Don't do that. Go to a Surya Narayan temple, or go to, or get it done in a temple where Surya Devata is the Pradhana Devata. That has a lot of power and impact. Okay, so where he is the presiding deity. So in such temples you should do. We at poojas.in, as you already know, we do these japas, homas, abhishekas, everything we do. But the abhishekas are always performed in the temples dedicated to that particular graha. So Surya Narayan temple only the abhisheka will be performed in your name and star, if you choose to do this. Now the third option is that you could go for a 12 mukhi rudraksha. Now, Ekamukhi Rudraksh, 12 Mukhi Rudraksh, both are governed by Surya only. But we recommend you to go for a 12 mukhi because it has more powerful properties, and it also has the power to control the other 9 planets, which is why it is on an expensive side. But it's a one-time investment, because once you buy Rudraksha, which is a good certified bead, it stays with you for all your life. And even after some time, you don't want to wear it. You can re-energize it and give it to your children. You know, it will really help a lot, because 12 mukhi Rudraksha is just not to please your boss or anything like that. Anything to do with Surya, you get the benefit. You get name, you get fame, you get recognition at work and in the society, and even your vision improves. I'm talking about the eyes, the physical eyes, especially your right eye will function very well, and your relationships will get better. If you have a job which is more related to associating with the government agencies or the government directly, you'll start getting cooperation from the government. You basically increase your charisma also. So 12 mukhi Rudraksha has all these properties, which is why I'm saying that if you have a budget, please go for that. And then the Homa, the Havan kind of a category, if we have to tell, we would always recommend Aditya Hridaya Parayana followed by Havan. Very, very powerful. These mantras were given to Lord Rama, and he also recited this before he went on a war with Ravana. But what I want to say is, here you're not doing any war against anybody, but you are in the process of doing Aditya Hridaya Homa. You're actually removing all negativity which is actually in between you and your boss. So there is some energy which is creating this disharmony between you both. Maybe a lack of understanding, lack of cooperation, lack of recognition. And it may be something like you yourself are not respecting your boss. Maybe you have excess ego, or maybe your boss is not, corresponding well with you. You know, it's mutual, because we say it takes two hands to clap, right? So it's just not one-sided story. It's not that only the boss is bad, or it's not just that you are not good. It's not both. I'm just saying that, you make things work for you. And you here means both of you, you and your boss. So do these remedies, they're very good. If you are doing, Argya to Surya Bhagwan every morning, starting from a Sunday, that should be a lifelong ritual that you can do. And if you can do Surya Namaskar, if your health permits you to do Surya Namaskar, if your fitness permits you, please go ahead and do Surya Namaskar every day. So I won't give you numbers like these many, like that, because every individual is different. See, monetarily, I can say that if you have a small pocket, do this. Slightly larger, go for Abhisheka. Slightly bigger, go for Rudraksh. And Havan is the best. But physical aspect of it, I won't be able to tell you, because each of you is different and your health conditions will be different and your flexibility will be different. So I would want you to decide whether you can do, or you should let go. But offering water to Surya Bhagwan every morning, that is Argya after your bath, before 8 in the morning, if you do the Argya, we call it, Argya, that is like chanting Om Namo Bhagavate Suryaya Namaha and offering water to Surya Bhagwan 3 times. So 3 times you chant the mantra and 3 times you offer water. So if you do this also, it's very good, and you will definitely see improvement in your career. In your entire personality will change. You will start attracting people, and they start noticing your work. They start, they feel that you have some potential which they may have not yet observed so far, So they may feel like, oh, actually this person has some substance in him or her. They're actually doing a lot of work. He has talent, or she's extremely good at work. So like that, they will start recognizing your work, and you may get promoted, you may get better opportunities in the same company, or you may even get good offers from other companies. So I am saying that the limit, I always tell in all my videos, that we may limit our mind thinking this is what was going to happen, this is the outcome of this puja, of this effort, like that. But divinity is infinite. And the power of divinity is infinite. And Navagrahas are a part of the divinity. Just like you and me are also a part of the divinity, Navagrahas are also a part of divinity, but they vibrate in a higher frequency. So they have more powers. So they can actually empower us. So if you do what I'm just suggesting in this video, definitely the whole of your personality will change, your charisma will improve, and your equation with your boss definitely is going to improve. Try it out and leave the comments below this video after trying. You try at least for a week or two and you tell me how you feel. So I'm seeing that, you know, like when I also practice all these things, so every week I see a change. So it's not like, you know, nothing is going to happen in the first week, you know. You have to do it for 12 weeks, then only you will get some change or some, I won't say that, because every step you take, every step you walk, you're actually walking towards your own progress. So whether the distance is already set between you and your boss, so you have to make that step closer to make it good for both of you. So try it out. I'm sure every week you're going to see a change, but I would like you to tell me what kind of changes you saw and how you felt. So just leave a comments below this video, and you can subscribe to my channel if you feel this video is useful, and you know, such videos are going to really help you in your life. Please do subscribe to our channel. Thank you. And if you want to take personalized consultation, you can always call me, and we can take it forward. Thank you so much. Take care. All the best.